guys, I hope you are doing well. I'm here today with another bag reveal, and it's coming to an end, you guys. I finished my Louis Vuitton wishlist. I was not able yet to film everything and show it on my channel, but Louis Vuitton wishlist is done. I'm so happy because unfortunately right now it's not always a super happy experience to go to the Louis Vuitton store. I had a lot of trouble with certain items to find them, to get a good one, to deal with the SAs, and at one point I drove to 5 different Louis Vuitton stores to find the right piece. And on the weekend, not because I have so much pleasure time, but because I wanted to finish it this year. I started in March, we are in September now, and I am finished. I'm super, super happy, and I put a lot of effort into it. And yes, I want to reveal another bag to you guys, which was definitely not 100%. I have a wish list with items I really, really, really need to have, and a wish list with items where I'm thinking about, I'm not sure. I have alternative items to substitute that item, and I was not sure if I really want to spend the money to get the actual item, which was buzzing in my head since 6 months. And I looked at this item plenty times and always decided no, it's not worth it. The alternative I have is better. And I said that also to everybody who was talking to me about this bag. And some might be shocked now that I got this bag, but now with the price increase standing in the room, and I confirmed with 4 different SAs that most likely this video will be uploaded after the price increase, because the price increase supposedly is tomorrow. We have today September 30, and the price increase is supposed to hit on October 1st. I think I will upload this video next week Friday, so 1 week later. And the price increase will hit, so I had definitely a little bit towards the end fear of missing out and didn't want to spend, because 2 of the SAs told me that the price increase is not only 6% for certain items, it might go up to 14% and 16%. So I decided I don't want to wait until this hits. I want to get my stuff before. And I'm sorry about the lightning. It's sunny and then it's again cloudy and again sunny and again cloudy, so I cannot do much about it right now. So the bag we are talking about is, ta-da-da-da, drum roll, it is the Pochette Matisse in reverse monogram. And this bag is just beautiful. But you know which alternative I was talking about. I was talking about the Coach Cassie. I am a big fan of the Coach Cassie. I love that bag. I have 5 different styles of the Coach Cassie and love to wear that bag. But for as my excuse, sorry, I can only say if you've been bitten by the bug, you are bitten by the bug. But I'm stopping now. And all the future videos you will see are purchases I made over the summer. After this, there is no more purchases coming for me from Louis Vuitton. So this is the bag. And the reason why I said yes was I believe in fate, even with bags. I know that sounds ridiculous to some, but for me it is like that. Some bags are meant to be yours and some are just not. So I was looking for a bag, which I at the end also got, but I was looking for a bag and I went to different Louis Vuitton stores, and in this particular store there's a very nice lady, and as you know, my whole collection is made in France, and I went to 5 stores that day and all of them had that particular bag only made in USA. So I went in and she said to me, only made in USA. She knows me, so I said, okay, I'll pass. And then I asked for the pochette Matisse. I actually wanted to watch a look at the monogram again. I looked at it plenty times, but I never had this, okay, I have to get it now. So she said to me, I have the reverse monogram. It just came today morning. I just unpacked it and put it here in the drawer. And I said, okay, let me see. So she showed it to me, and for some reason, I never thought that the reverse monogram will be appealing to me, but I thought of cafe au lait, espresso, chocolate, dark chocolate, milk chocolate, and I love chocolate, and I had to have it. And I got it yesterday, and I came home very late, and I will have the unboxing run here. The unboxing is not as usual with clear light or anything. I actually planned to make the unboxing next day, but I couldn't go to sleep without unpacking this bag and looking at it all night. So I just unboxed it for you guys in my bedroom, and it will be running here, right here, hopefully, with my technical skills. And you can see how I unboxed it. And afterwards, I watched this bag has so much, how do you say, press. So many people reviewed this bag, mostly about the issues it has, and I just hope for the best. But I was rewatching videos yesterday, and there are so many issues with this bag, and I last night, every video who said this is an issue, I went over this bag and went, okay, this is fine, take off. And I will give you a quick walkthrough now through this bag and show you what all I looked at in detail. And we are doing,
guys, I wanted to give you a quick roundup and walkthrough from outside of the bag. This is the strap. The strap has 5 holes and is adjustable and removable. And the bag has this S-lock where you just push one side and then it flaps open. This other side is just to hold on to. When you close it, you just close it back up. It has this little tab. Here, this is a treated leather tab. And this is the reverse monogram, and this is the classic monogram. And I love how these little pleats here inside are reverse monogram, and the outside of the bag is the classic monogram. I watched gazillions of videos and went through the flaws. One lady made a review. She said her tabs were super loose, so loose that whenever she wanted to hold a top handle, it flapped out. So this is not the case here. I went through the stitching. If the stitching is appropriate, it's double stitched. Nothing is loose, no threads coming out, nothing of that sort. I also went through the inside stitching here, injected all out. Then I checked another lady in another video. I watched so many, I don't remember who that was, but she said that her LVs were not aligned, and you should watch out that the L, the bottom part of the L, does not go over the stitching. And it does not here in this bag. Then I checked, of course, outside the zipper. Super smooth, super nice. And I went through all, because the pochette Matisse had glazing issues and they redid this many, many times. I went 150,000 times over the glazing of this bag here. And all looks very, very good to me. The issues that this bag has is the glazing, still, I think. And people report that when you open the bag, it can come to cracking over here. But you know, every bag has their own risks. And yeah, when you buy them, they are not invincible. Treat them nicely and hope for the best. That's my motto. That was my quick walkthrough, and now we are doing a what's in my bag. And after that, I'll give you some more shots.
Decided to make a little walkthrough from the inside. One pocket in the back, a big pocket here in the center, a quite big expandable pocket here in the front, and then you also have the zippered pocket here in the back, which I don't want to fill up with my phone at all, because I did the mistake with my Cassie and it left an indent here, so I'm not going to do the same mistake again.
So and you saw the walkthrough, and everything so far looks good on this one, and everything is fine for my understanding. And I decided definitely to keep it, use it, and see. I anyway am always pretty gentle with my bags, so I have MCM bags since 5, 6, 7 years, and they still have the protective sticker on. This is what I'm also having on here. I'm keeping this on, which came with the Louis Vuitton bag. Don't know if you can see that. It has the protective sticker on, and I will keep it on. And I ordered off Etsy more protective stickers, so that in case this falls off, I can put another one on, because I do not want this to be scratched. Because a lot of ladies mentioned when you open this bag that when you put it back closed, that this little thing can scratch the hardware over here. And I don't want that to happen, of course. Another thing which I found very interesting was that the pochette Matisse in the classic monogram is $20.50 right now before the price increase. I don't know what's going to happen after October 1st. And the reverse was the same price, $20.50. But the mini palm springs, in the classic, I will look for the price, but I looked it up today morning, and the difference in price between the reverse monogram and the classic monogram was about $150, which I thought was interesting. And I recall also that this one was $50 or $60 more expensive before than the classic one. But I mean, you know, when you talk a 2K bag, then $50 more or less is not such a big difference, but $150 is, in my opinion. So that's something to think about if you want something in reverse monogram. These are the two bags I was looking at, but I'm very much in love with my MCM BB Boo and decided I don't need another mini backpack. But these I can always wear very nicely, because you can, with the chain, you can make this even an evening bag. You can wear this casual, you can wear this dressy, you can wear this in all kinds of different ways. And on top, you can wear it in all different weather conditions. And yeah, now we will do a what fits, and after the what fits, I'm going to give you some mod shots. And I hope you enjoyed this little bag reveal. I put always to get as much as I can into these reveals, so that it's not just a reveal and unboxing. You are getting also a what fits, you are getting some mod shots. So if you are thinking about buying this bag, so you have a roundabout idea what you are dealing with. If you have any more questions about this, please leave me a comment. I'm always happy to revisit this bag, especially since I'm going to wear this now a little bit, and check it out for you. So I hope you enjoy the what fits and the mod shots, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I'm really in love with the combination with the reverse monogram. Like when you open it, the contrast, I love it. I love it, love it, love it. On top, I love that it's you don't have to worry about the weather. I mean, I love vachetta. Don't get me wrong. Most of my bags are vachetta bags from Louis Vuitton.
But I definitely appreciate also a rainproof bag which I can carefree take to the park or to a theme park or wherever, and when a downpour comes I don't have to worry much about it. So let's go to the what's in my bag now. Not what's in my bag, this is the first time I'm filling that bag up, and I choose a few SLGs and we will see together how that fits in here. This is the inside, by the way. And I was super lucky. I got, again, a made in France piece. And I'm extremely happy about that. So let's go from here. I think you can see it this way the best. And the back, I'm putting my agenda and my mini pochette. Like so. Then I'm putting some wipes in. I put them here in the front because this bag seems to be more spacious than the Cassie, and I will definitely 100% promise make a comparison with the Cassie. I know there are a few out there, but everybody's perception is different, so I definitely make one for you. Putting the zippy in here, my wallet and my key holder. And I'm putting a Lysol here at the side, this side here. And there's still space. You could still fill this up. I'm not planning to fill this bag up like crazy. Putting a mask in, an extra mask. And that's it for me and my essentials, but you definitely could put in much more stuff if you wanted to. But I don't want to expand the bag too much. And that's why this is good for me. So we are closing the bag now. Closed. And now I will give you some Modshots. Tell me what to do.